Okay, what's today's question? Let's see. Oh, another long one. I listened to an ICC teacher using an expression, looking as, when they spoke about skills that ICC coaches build when they study with you. What does looking as mean, and why is it so important in your training? So let me read it for you and for me again. I listened to an ICC teacher using an expression, looking as, when they spoke about skills that ICC coaches build when they study with you. What does looking as mean, and why is it so important in your training? Yeah, it is a phrase. Let me try and elaborate what that means. And hopefully by the end of this discussion, when you hear the word looking as now, it'll mean something different to you. So as a coach, when you're working with a client, you know, you're trying to become attuned to understand what their coaching topic is. You're trying to understand who they are, what's important to them, how they've approached their topic up to now. And you're really trying to understand at a pretty deep level how they see, orient, and relate to things, to the world, to things, how they relate to themselves and others, what's in their grasp of reality, like what do they see and not see in their world, how do they make sense of things, what are their values, what are their capability sets, what do they draw upon and not. So there's a whole profile of many facets to understanding a client. And in many approaches and in many disciplines, actually, in our part of the world, we develop skills usually to look at something, like to look at a person, to look at a house, or to look at things. And then we do some assessments and draw some conclusions about it. So if you're just looking at skill sets, for example, you might look at someone and try and assess their skill levels and then, you know, report out what their skill levels are. Often coaches are, you know, sport coaches are doing that. They're looking at the athlete to see what they can and cannot do and so on and so forth. And that's very important. It's an objective look at what's here, what's not. But that approach, that perspective, is like me over here looking at that over there and drawing a conclusion. And yet in coaching, at least in our approach to coaching, to truly meet a client in their world, you have to be able to sort of look through their eyes and be able to see what they see and get access to how they navigate in the world. What do they pay attention to? What are they afraid of? What is important to them? How does their body react in any given moment? How do they carry themselves through their topic or their situation, their challenge? What are they able to draw upon and not? But from a feeling place, like feeling like you're in that person's body and in that being. Because if you can access that, then you can work with your client at a deeper level of both exploring and shining light on their interior as well as their exterior. It allows you to meet them where they are, and then they feel met and feel like you're with them through the journey. But it's tough to do that. It's easy to say, yeah, I'll try and walk in someone else's shoes. But how do you know you're in their shoes or your shoes? It's actually quite a skill to develop. And it's one level of skill to kind of be able to look at something and maybe have some different lenses or assessment models to help you categorize something or rate something or understand something. So it's me looking at something and then drawing a conclusion. So that's a certain set of perspectives. But to be able to know how you look, set that down and find a way in to look as this client and how this client looks at the world and themselves, that is way more complicated. And it takes a lot of development to hold that kind of multi-perspective perspective taking. And in our school, we feel that's important, to be able to have that capacity to take those multiple perspectives, both looking at and looking as, and draw on both in how they work with a client. And so our work from the first module, the associate module, through all levels, their training is designed to help build both. And they develop the ability to also know how to look at themselves as well as look as themselves, so that they have the ability to take the personal responsibility of not unconsciously being driven by how they see things, but they're able to literally say, I know this is how I see it, and I'm able to slip into another view. And that's a level of integrity that we feel quite proud about, and that coaches from our school hold in a very high regard. It's a hard skill to build, but it allows a coach to be sure that they're being of true service to the client versus unconsciously sort of trying to get the client to do whatever works for me. So that's the fuller description of what looking as means. And I do believe that skill set isn't just necessary for integral coaches in our school, but I do believe that capacity is the kind of capacity that's going to allow us in this crazy globe of ours to be able to interact with people and navigate in places where we don't see the same. How can we get better at looking as others? And when that happens, one of the other things I didn't mention earlier, to look as, you've got to open your heart. It's not a mental function. To feel someone else's world and see through their world, your heart has to be involved. And so I think if we could all do that, to be able to look as others, not just in our minds, but in our hearts, as well as own our own views, some good things could happen. So I hope this inspires you, and that perhaps you'll go out and explore, how can I do that just in some part of my world? Even with your children, your teenager, your spouse, it can do wonders. So thanks again for the question, and have a great day. I hope you enjoyed the video where I talked about what looking as means and what it calls for as far as capability to be able to look as another human being. In this video, I wanted to just make a suggestion on how you could get started on developing your capability to look as, or advancing it in some way. I think the best step to get started is to actually work with a model that's one that defines distinct ways that people interpret, make meaning, get oriented in a given situation that then guides their kinds of behavior. Those kinds of models help you be able to sort of get outside your own view and begin to appreciate there's a distinct view, there's a distinct view, there's a distinct view, there's a distinct view. And in so doing, you'll be amazed at how, wow, there are distinct views that you never thought existed. And when you see that, you just go, whoa, no wonder we're so different. They literally come from a different place of interpreting. No wonder we don't click on something right away, or we're kind of at cross purposes in some fashion or form. It's not like they're, you know, trying to make it difficult for me. That's just how they see. So that can be so powerful, and a model really accelerates your ability to get access to that. A model also helps you really get to know your own way of making sense more accurately. So you can sort of own it better. You can kind of say, oh, that's me. Oh, I'm seeing that's my view that I'm holding here. Let me also be able to look as someone else and hold their view as well. So a model can really help you move along in that way. And the particular model that I want to talk about today is a model that we use in our coaching training that students learn. It's called Orienting Quadrants. It's a very powerful model, and it's also not too complex. Some can be very complex. So it's a great way to get started. And we do have a video series that we had produced called Native Perspectives. And it's a series that actually teaches you about this model and how you can start applying it. It's Joanne Hunt, who's the co-founder of Integral Coaching Canada. She's the one who is in these videos and is really your learning partner through the videos. She does a fabulous job. And of course, that's my opinion, but I think she just does a brilliant job, and I think you'll enjoy spending time with her. In these videos, you'll learn what are the four distinct views in this model and how to recognize yourself in those views and recognize others. The second thing is you'll start to see a link between the views and what the behaviors of that distinct view, because there's some unique connections there between how we interpret and how we behave. And so that's the second piece you'll learn. And the third piece, which is just mind-blowing actually, is realizing, oh, each view has a distinct way of relating to the other three views. And that is fascinating and quite illuminating. I can't tell you how many people, when they learn this part of it, go, oh, that explains so much. And it opens the door, truly, to really feeling motivated to go, wow, how can I learn about seeing through the eyes of that other person? Because that's going to make such a difference in how we interact with each other, what language I choose, how we get started so we can find some common ground. It's a massive, massive help to not only looking as, but then communicating from having that ability. So in addition to the videos, there's also some guidelines and some practices that really help you develop what I just described. And the videos themselves take place in a meeting setting. And we chose that because, well, a lot of people are in meetings. Perhaps you are too. And that's an area where I think many, many, many of us would love to get better at it. And so this video series does provide examples in that setting. And of course, you can apply this in other kind of situations where two or more people are in a conversation. It's a great series. It could be a great way for you to get going on developing your ability to look as others and then have that help you advance how you're in conversation with other people in a way that they feel seen. You both are able to communicate and get things done. So I hope you found this interesting, and please check out the video series if that's something that you're interested in. And as always, I wish you well. Take care.